Hello, my name is Ramses Marsili, and I am the library liaison to the health sciences. So what I wanted to do today was kind of have a brief introduction to the library and its services and features. And in a couple of weeks, I will be stopping by the classroom and doing a full instruction. This is just sort of, as I said, an introduction to kind of get you a little bit more acquainted with it before we start doing, really diving into some research when I go into the classroom. So let me share my screen. And today I'm gonna go a little bit between just kind of going through our homepage on our library services live and maybe show you a couple of PowerPoint slides here and there. So first thing I would like to show you is our homepage, that is library.fiu.edu. And within the homepage here, just a quick reminder that the first thing you should always do is to log in for access, especially when you're accessing it remotely from home or wherever else outside of the library. So you will log here for access, and now we have two different types of login. It should just be Easy Proxy, and that is being substituted with Open Athens. But at the moment, we're still kind of working with those. So the way you would sign up with Open Athens is by using the same credentials that you would use for Canvas, just your FIU username and password. And for Easy Proxy, what you would use is the 14-digit number in the back of your Panther card as your username. And as your password, it will be the month and day of your birthday in 4-digit form. So you do need your Panther card for that. So I'm just gonna quickly log into Open Athens. I have already been previously logged in, so it's not going to ask for my credentials. It's just gonna take me directly back to our homepage. Now, another feature that I want to make you aware of is right here, this little widget, which allows you to create a chat with the librarian. So you could do that Monday through Friday, 10 till 8, and even on the weekend, Saturday and Sunday, 12 to 6, you can actually talk to a librarian. A few other features are interlibrary loans. So what happens is we do have a lot of material, but we don't have everything. So if there's something that you really need and we don't have it, you can access it through interlibrary loans. In the full session, we'll go into how to set up an account, and we'll get you set up with that. As far as searching, we have sort of streamlined everything by subject to make it a little more accessible to you. So we usually always start with research start. Then we will go into subject resources. And here we will look for dietetics and nutrition. So when we come to this landing page, you have two tabs here, guides and databases. Now, as you can see, these guides are just, they're library guides, we call them lib guides. And what they do is, well, they really sort of make your life a lot easier by explaining a lot of the features and a lot of the process and methodology that you would have to go through in order to do correct research. Now, some of these guides, as you can see, they're specific by database. Some of them might be class specific, some of them even like assignment specific. But we have here quite a bit, we have guides on Medline, public health, SANAL. So what I wanted to do is sort of explore the dietetics and nutrition guide, which is sort of a good overall guide that you can use to help yourself. So here, and once again, in the full lecture, we will go through it in a lot more detail. But here you'd have ways of finding background information, not just ways, but the actual resources that are available to you, ways and resources to find articles, the difference between scholarly sources and peer-reviewed and not peer-reviewed, how to find books, media, and more, finding statistics, finding government, you know, local, county, state, and federal resources will be here. So once again, we will go into that in a lot more greater detail during our session. I wanted to sort of focus a little bit on finding articles, since it's going to be what you do the most. And oh, it's thinking about it. Ah, here we are. So when it comes to finding articles, here it shows you some of the databases that you will be using the most. So we have the Health and Science and Nursing databases, Combined Search. We have PubMed, which you're probably already familiar with. We have Medline, two different interfaces with Medline. But what Medline is the same as PubMed, just a different way to search for them. And I do like to include them because once we learn how to do, you know, construct our search strategy and come up with our keywords on our date range and, you know, narrow it down in all those ways, you know, gender, sex, publication type, then searching in Medline becomes a little bit easier, or, you know, more familiar than the way you've been doing it at PubMed. Sorry about that. So we have Cochrane, we have Agricola, which is really great, nutrition abstracts and reviews, CINAHL, plus with text, which, you know, it indexes, you know, over 3,000 journals in nursing, biomedicine, health sciences, and which is also actually combined with health sciences and nursing databases, combined search. So CINAHL will be included here. Let me close this up. So we will be searching and we'll be creating a search strategy, which sounds, you know, more difficult than it is. It really isn't. Once we get to those databases. Now, if you go back to our landing page, where we had guides and databases and click on databases, then you will see we have here our best bets, and you will see a lot of the same ones that we had in the previous page by going through the guide. What we also have here is all these additional databases that you can use should your research demand that you go this way, or should you want to explore a lot of these databases. So some of them may not be directly related to dietetics and nutrition or health sciences, but you know, peripherally related to them. So of course we have a great reference and background source here, Encyclopedia of Foreign Culture, Encyclopedia of Human Nutrition. So it's not just a way of finding articles, but it's also a way of finding background information. So let's take a quick look, for example, at CINAHL. Excuse me. And part of our building our research strategy is understanding how the search functions in these databases work, which we will go into you know, a greater deal of detail, obviously, in the live session. But okay, now as you can see here, we have three separate search bars, and you can also expand it or, you know, subtract from it. The way it looks this way is because when we do our research, the best way to do it is by taking the main point of your research question, of your research question, and then each one of them, once you have identified them, they become your search terms. So let's say, for example, that I was looking for the effect of carbonated drinks on mental health. So if you really, if I analyze that statement, my main points or my key concepts are carbonated drinks and mental health. And then this will become my search terms. See, it actually helps you build them a little bit. So let's pick carbonated beverages here. And mental health. Going to click search. And then we will have our results. Now, when we do the live session, of course, we're going to go into this, you know, research strategy. We're going to delve into it a lot deeper. We're going to find out how to use this, the Boolean characters, you know, a little deeper way, how to expand and subtract, you know, and reduce your results at the same time in a more meaningful fashion. Also, how to use the rest of our search strategy, which includes publication date, major subheadings, age, gender, publication type. We could go into all of that in greater detail. The way you would find it is you would either click at find it at FIU, or sometimes it says it will take you directly to either HTML full text or PDF full text. Later on, we will find out how to save our searches either through a citation manager or emailing it to yourself, how to look and find for citations. And most importantly, what I always want to get the most out of our sessions is that we are here to help. So I'm just going to close this very short session with my contact info. Should you have any questions before we meet live with the class, please know that you could always contact me and get in touch. I'm happy to do sessions either over the phone or over Zoom, in person if you're here in the library. So once again, this is just a very short introduction. Hopefully you get something out of it before I come into class. But once I get it, but you know, once we start working together, you'll see that research is really not, you know, a scary process. Once we break it down and we come up with our research strategy, it's actually very simple. It's a very flexible process. And more importantly than anything, if you do run into trouble, you do have me here for help. All right. So we'll see you guys later. Thank you.